Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In our previous lecture, we were discuss about how to start composer, the various parts of composer and how to create new file in composer. Today, we will talk about how to open an existing file, how to create form and one sample copy of a small form. Now many students ask me the question about the practical exam. So what I will discuss in this video and what you will get in next video lecture, both will be helpful to you to solve your practical exam question number one, prepare HTML form with the help of Composer. So with this, we will go ahead in our standard 12 introduction to computer subject, chapter number 1, the next part. Okay, how to open an existing file. Now students, it can be asked in exam that how many ways you can able to open an existing file according to textbook. There are 3 methods. Okay, let's read them. To open an existing file, click on open icon. Okay, that is available on composition toolbar. Alternatively, click on file and open. And if the file is been opened recently, then it will be available in file and recent pages. So these are the ways how you can able to open an existing file. Students, the area which I tick mark now, look at this. Now this particular icon can be asked in exam. Observe the following icon carefully and find out it relate with which facility. Or it can be also asked that among the following, which is the correct icon to open the file. Okay, so let's see all these 3 ways in our Composer. This is Composer software. And this is your open icon. You can able to see this. One more way, file and open file. This is also possible, file and open file. And one more is file, recent page. See, file and recent page, recent pages. Okay, so these are the ways how you can able to open an existing file. We open this file for reference. Now let us learn to create a form using Composer. We will create a simple form with 2 input fields, name and email address and submit button. See, we will create one form, but in that form we will ask a person to enter the name and enter the email address. Okay, and we will provide submit button. For that purpose, we have to follow the steps. Open the Composer and create new file. So we'll do one thing. We will create new file, file and new and create. So this new file is available from the menu bar. Now how to create form? See, from the menu bar, select insert form and define form. Insert form and define form. Or you can also click on form icon of composition toolbar and this will open form properties dialog box. Please remember which dialog box can be asked, that when you click on insert form and define form, which dialog box is open. So it is form properties dialog box as shown in figure 1.4. So you can able to see this form properties dialog box available. Okay. Now we will work out with this. We go with menu first, insert form and the first one define form. Look at this. insert, form, and define form. You have to click over here on define form. Sequence is insert, form, and define form. Okay. Second way is on the composition toolbar. Here we have a form icon, but you have to click on this small triangle. So if you click on small triangle, you can able to see here also define form is available. Here also define form is available. So we'll click on that. So you get the same dialog box, form properties dialog box. Here you have to write the name of the form, action URL, and method get or post. Students will already discuss about these three. Okay, you have to give the name for identity purpose. Action URL means the place where the fill up data of form will submitted, and a method that is get and post. So all these three part we already discussed. Okay, now see what textbook says. Enter appropriate name of the form, and in action URL enter the file name where you want the form data to be submitted. Now this line asked in board exam. In action URL enter the file name where you want the form data to be submitted. If you remember in my previous video of the same lesson, I clarified that here we have to clarify the name of the server, and in that server in which file all this fill up data stored, that I have to clarify in action attribute. So here also it is the same. Now select the method. Okay, that is the method is post from the method drop down menu, and click on OK button. Now in figure 1.5 it mentioned what to write: form name form 1, action URL form 1.html, and method is post, and then they click on OK button. We also do the same thing. In form name I mentioned form 1, action URL form 1.html, and method is post. Okay, now what textbook says? See, they say now you have to click on OK button. So we will click on OK button. Now I want your attention. Look at the mouse cursor. This area, if you concentrate, you will see something. After I click on OK button, so concentrate now. I hope you are able to see this blue color dotted line. See, this blue color dotted line is our form area. Our whole form we will prepare in this particular box. But you must have a question. How the whole form will fix over here? If you press enter, see the area increase. Okay, and now you can click and can create whatever you wish. Okay, now just read the textbook page, page number 9. You can see the form inserted with underline light blue colored outline in the untitled page as shown in figure 1.6. Now light blue colored outline can be asked in exam. 1.6 figure, in normal view the form are shown surrounded by dotted blue box. You can able to see here we have normal view and a blue dotted line is this one. Okay, all the form elements like text box, radio button, checkbox, and drop down box will be placed within this box, and press enter key, please underline, press enter key few times to give some space to work on the form. So enter key you have to mark. Okay, Next, after figure 1.6, first we will insert a label for the name field. Okay, enter your name, that is called label, and then the box available. So we will create label. Remember the menu sequence, this pink writing, please underline. Insert, form, and define label. I repeat, menu sequence, insert, form, and define label. After giving this command, place the cursor in the form where you want your label to appear. Okay, so we will do exactly the same thing. Look at this, insert, form, and here we have define label. Look at the menu sequence. Insert, form, define label. Okay, the same thing you can receive, same thing you can create with the help of this icon also, same thing. Okay, so insert, form, and define label. My cursor is here right now, so I start writing. I give my label name. Now students, here almost 85% students make mistake. After writing the label name, you have to click outside. See my mouse cursor, you have to click outside the box and then you have to give the space. Now if you not click outside, then everything will go in label only. By clicking the outside of the dotted box, we are saying that now we are not a part of that label. Now we are writing other than label. Okay. Now place the cursor in the form we already did. Type the text name in the label as shown in figure 1.7. Now this part majority students make mistake in exam, practical exam. To come out from the label, click outside the field. Maximum students make mistake over here. They not click outside and then they are arguing in practical exam that, sir, everything is not working properly in this computer. So that is why I underline and I insist you also underline. After writing label, you have to click outside. So you can see in textbook, they also prepare label like name over here. Okay. Next, on page number 10. Now, we need to insert input text field. So for that purpose, to insert an input text field in the form, click on underline insert form and form field. We have to go to insert form and form field. Figure 1.8 shows the form field properties dialog box. Which dialog box? I hope you can able to make out. The dialog box is field properties dialog box. Here also it is available. So I just mark properly so you remember. The drop down menu. This is drop down menu. This is drop down menu. Shows various input field option which we had discussed earlier. Now click on more properties. It shows advanced properties related to the field like size, maximum length, etc. Now we will do up to this. We go for insert. The cursor is available. If you wish, you can still go for space, your choice. Where this blinking cursor available, at that place it creates the box. So insert, form, form field, you can able to see this. This is drop down list. Here you have to write the name of the box, initial value if you want to keep anything. And here we have more properties. If you click on more properties, you can clarify the size. Size means what? Size means what is, how many alphabet visible at the same time. You can insert crores of alphabet. There is no limit. But the width of the boxes depend on how many characters you want to be visible at the same time. And for that purpose, we have to set field size. Maximum length also you can able to set, but we don't want to go in detail. And here we have a drop down menu. You can create all these things. Whenever it asks in exam to create text box, password box, checkbox, radio button, submit button, and reset. This is what we have in our syllabus. Okay. So to create all this, you need to go for same sequence. Okay. Insert. Okay. Then form. Okay. And the sequence as mentioned here. Insert form and form field. Okay. The same sequence to create all this item. To create all this item, you need to go for same sequence. Now we will select text only because we want to create text box. And now you see what is given in textbook. From the drop down menu, select text. And under the field settings heading, enter a name in the field name box. In our case, we have used the name as the field name. What is the name of the box? I write name only. The name of the box is name only. You can give any other also, I don't mind. Name of the box is name only. Then initial value. Enter some text in the initial value. If you want to show some text before the user actually enters the data, you want something to be available in the box before user try to enter some data. Here we have left this field empty because right now we don't want anything as a default name. Then it is mentioned that click on OK button, and figure 1.9 shows the form after text input field is added. So you can able to see it look like this. So I click on OK button. Students, I hope you notice this particular box is available now. Okay. Next, similarly, we will add another label email below the name label field. Add an input text field for email, just like we did for the name field. Same way we have to create label, and same way we have to create input text field. But here, enter the text abc@xyz.com in the initial value, default value text box. And this will helpful to understand the user what is the format of email address. So we'll follow. I press enter key. So I hope you can able to see blinking cursor is here where my mouse is moving. Here we have blinking cursor. To create label, what we have to do? Insert form, define label, and we will write here email. As I told you, again there is a very high chance that people make mistake in practical exam. After you complete your writing of label, click outside of the box and go for space. Okay. Now how to create box? Insert form, form field. Okay, sequence is insert form, form field, and in that insert form, form field, write down the field name. You have to write down the field name here. We, because text box we want to create, that is available as it is. So in field name I will write email, and initial value, what is to be initial value? Students, it is given over here. Read here, enter the text abc@xyz.com in the initial value, in the initial value text box. Okay, So we will also write abc@xyz.com. See, abc@xyz.com. And I will click on OK button. So I hope you can able to see. It comes with default text abc@xyz.com. Now after figure 1.10, finally we will add a submit button in the form. Now how to create submit button? Sequence is same. Insert form and form field. Okay, and from the drop down menu select. From the drop down menu you need to select submit button. You need to select submit button. And you have to type submit in both field name and field value. Here we have a field name. Here we have a field value. In both we will write submit and then we click on OK button. Now we will do it. Right now cursor is at the end of this box. I'll press enter 2 times. Then I go for space. Now here I want submit button. Insert. Form. Form field. I hope you remember this. Insert. Form. Form field. Okay. You see what happened. Same dialog box. We create text box with the help of this. Now we need to go for submit button. Here we have a submit button, see. So we will create submit button. And the field name and field value box. In the field name and field value box, we will write submit submit. Okay. Now, after writing submit submit in both the box, we have to click on OK button. And I hope you are able to see submit button is also available. Now, after creating submit button, page number 12, the form at present in, the form is right now in normal view. And to have a preview of the form, click on edit mode toolbar. And select the preview. So it will look like figure 1.12. We will do this. Right now we are with normal view. But we will select preview. The moment when I click on preview. Okay. The red outline. This red outline is removed. That is this red outline removed. Okay. See, I click on preview here. You notice all the red lines and other things are removed. Preview will tell you how it will look like, how it will look like when you upload this for the people who can able to open the website. Thus, we have created our first form using Composer. And you can see how Composer helps you creating forms within a short span and also relieves you from the tedious job of writing the source code, which takes long time. That's but nature, I hope you remember. In Notepad method, to create a form, we have to write, you know, huge amount of things. But here in Composer, within a very short span and very fast, you can able to design your form and you will be relieved from the tedious job. Now you can also see the source code. Okay, please underline. You can see the source code by just clicking on source tab. Okay. Now here we have a source tab. See. Here we have a source tab. So if you click on source, it will show you the tabs. Look at this. These are the tags used to create the all the parts of HTML form. You can see a tag is available by itself. Input name is equal to submit. This is the best part of Composer. Whatever you create over here, its tag automatically comes here. See? Okay. We create na input type is equal to text and all those input type is equal to submit. See? Here it is mentioned. Input type is equal to submit. Okay, so submit button available. All, you remember NBSP we discussed in the third lecture or second lecture, and NBSP, that is space. So whenever you design anything in Composer, its tag automatically comes here. That is the best part of Composer. Next, let us save the file which we have created. Now see, compared to other software, in Composer, when you try to save the file, the rules are a little bit different. So please concentrate properly. Let us save the file which we have created. Click on File and Save. Alternatively, you can also click on the button. Which button? That is Save button. This is the Save button in the Composition toolbar. And this open. Remember, whenever you try to save the file, it open page title dialog box first, and you need to give suitable title of your web page. In textbook they have given example 1 to the title page. Okay, so how can you save the file? Either File or Save, or you can click on Save button. I'll show you both. Here we have a Save button. I hope you can able to see this. And File, and then Save also available over here. See, File, Save. Okay. Now when you try to save, you see here it is not asked the file name first. Remember, in Composer, whenever you try to save the file first time, it will ask to enter the title first, and then it asks to enter the name of the file. Okay. So here we go for the title. The title mentioned here, that is the title mentioned here, that is example 1, which we have to write in this box. This is page title dialog box. Okay. Teacher like me who want to set the paper, they ask that in page title dialog box, how many buttons are there? And last board exam, such type of questions were there. You can able to see the last year's board exam paper, and you can able to find out that type of questions were there in board exam paper. So we will write here example 1. Okay. And I click on OK button. Please concentrate. The moment when I click on OK button, it responds with the dialog box. It responds with the dialog box. Okay. And this dialog box, you need to write file name. Here you have to write name of the file. But before you want to give the name of the file, refer the paragraph. Please underline this whole paragraph, because number of time MCQ asked from this paragraph. So please underline the first point. The page title which you give, example 1, will display on the browser window title bar on top when you view in the browser. Now in the case, if you are creating or created multiple web pages, we should give the name of website as a title page. For example, you are preparing the website of Flipkart. Okay. And in that you have to create multiple web pages. So the best part is what? You put the title Flipkart. So all the page has title Flipkart. So when you are creating multiple web pages, you should give the name of the website as title. Those area which I underline, I insist you also underline. In our example, we are creating single web page, so we give the title as example 1. Okay, here we give title as example 1. After clicking on OK button, a new dialog box save page as is open, which prompts to enter a file name and specify the location where you want to save the file, as shown in figure 1.15. You can able to see here where you want to save the file. That location you have to decide. Okay. And I am giving the name of the file is form1 on desktop. Form1. You can able to see the name I am giving form1 and the location is desktop. Okay. .html or .htm is compulsory. Look at the textbook. Remember to save, please underline, this also ask in board exam. Remember to save the file with .html or .htm as an extension. And then you have to click on save button. And this will take us back to the main window. So we will click on form1.html. I hope you can able to see .html. And I click on save button. So we come back to the main area. One note is given, please underline. If you are creating a website and if the page which we are creating is home page that will open when you type the website's URL, then save the page with name index.html. This same sentence available in chapter 3. The point says that if you are creating a website and if this particular page is your home page which will open when somebody open your website, then save this file with the name index.html, because it is always easy for server to find out the home page if you give the name of the file as index.html. So they are saying that when you are creating a website and if this page is the home page, then home page will be open when you enter the website name. In that case, the name of this file you need to provide is index.html. Okay, fine. So, having learned how to create, open, save and create a simple form in Composer, let us now create the registration form. If you remember, we created registration form earlier using HTML tag, lengthy method. And now we have to create this registration form with the help of Composer. But students, that particular part we will discuss in our next lecture. Okay, and that will be the probable last lecture of chapter number 1. Students, I want your help. Just write in the comment section, do you want me to conduct your online test with the help of Google Form? Those who are interested, please write in comment section yes, only for your practice purpose. Okay, the students who want me to conduct their online test with the help of Google Form, please write in the comment section so that I can able to take a decision whether I need to focus on this or not. And if you wish your friend also give the same test, tell them to write in the comment section. Okay, only one thing you have to write in comment section, that yes sir, I want to give chapter 1 test online. Okay, so with this I would like to end our today's lecture. And students, please take care of yourself. I'll pray for everyone. God bless all. Thank you.